5. It looks like there's a few people down.
Crime scene tape marked block after block of Chicago's most violent neighborhoods this weekend.
Everybody in this city should be tired of it.
Leaving the city's leaders deep in frustration.
This is not Chicago.
Exhausted by 4 chronically troubled police districts on the south and west sides, ones with high unemployment, closing schools, drugs, and illegal firearms, which echoed with gunfire Saturday and Sunday.
80 shots fired southwest of 2705 South Archer.
Funeral mourners were strafed, and so was a neighborhood block party. Tanika Humphrey's 17-year-old daughter was killed.
And it took my baby for
And yet, even after such carnage, a wall of silence shields the murderers and blocks their arrests.
If you know who did this, be a neighbor. Speak up. In the very neighborhoods this happened, there are good people.
If these are good people in the neighborhoods, why aren't they turning in the bad guys?
You know, that's a question we've been asking for quite some time. You know, so listen, that's something they have to do better at.
It's got to be tough on them.
Corey Brooks, pastor of the New Beginnings Church and an anti-violence activist, says people are afraid to come forward, and rightly so.
We have to do everything we can to create environments where people feel safe to go to the police and let the police know exactly what's going on.
But so far, no arrests in this weekend's violence. Last year, only 17.5% of the homicides here were solved. Jeff?
Wow. Dean Reynolds in Chicago, thank you.